Hi everybody, today is February 8th, 2013. Well, Evergreen Aviation admits to chemtrail weather modification contract with U.S. Air Force. Evergreen Aviation, one of the world's largest private aviation companies, admits to weather modification service on their own website. In the market section for their new supertanker, they state weather modification among other interesting service markets. Content copied directly from Evergreen Aviation website. Markets: firefighting, oil spill contamination, weather modification, biochemical decontamination. The Evergreen supertanker is not just limited to fighting fire. It will be a true unilateral aircraft with the capability to configure to different applications on short notice. This multi-mission aircraft can support sensitive security and environmental missions. The aircraft's exceptional drop capabilities, louder time, and size make it an ideal tool to perform challenging homeland security missions. Able to neutralize chemical attacks on military installations or major population centers, and help control large environmental disastrous oil spills. In addition, the upper deck of the Boeing 747 provides over 200 square feet of space that could be assigned as a command and control center. EIA possesses a FAA exemption number 1870C that permits the carriage of up to 5 individuals that are not crew members in the upper deck. This area is capable of providing space for command and control components that would assist in sophisticated mapping, including monitoring and video communications downlink relay that might require additional personnel over and above the required crew. What airports will Evergreen operate the supertanker out of? Evergreen will operate the aircraft from any major airport with sufficient ramp space to load the aircraft. These include civilian bases, joint use civilian military bases, and accessible military bases. Generally, the runway requirements for the Evergreen supertanker are 8,000 feet. Can the supertanker fight fires at night while they are most vulnerable? The supertanker utilizes advanced avionics and flies at high, safer altitudes, which will enable fire agency the option of fighting fires at night while they are dormant. Are there any other markets for the Evergreen supertanker? Can it operate globally? Evergreen is studying other applications for the supertanker: oil spill containment, chemical decontamination, and weather modification are all potential markets for this aircraft. Because the aircraft is pressurized, the Evergreen supertanker has the capability of any long-range Boeing 747 passenger aircraft. This allows the aircraft to deploy to any international location. If you want to read up for yourself on this, just go to gibiru.com. Do a search on weather control, and then start clicking the links that come up. You might find it surprising, as I did. Here's the bottom line. Is weather control real? Yes. Do we have the technology to create a hurricane or tornado or earthquakes? Yes. Who has this technology? The U.S. and Russia. But Russia has been offering the technology for sale. What specific technologies can be used to alter the weather and create storms? Several. High-energy lasers can be directed into the atmosphere, which creates free oxygen, O2. This combined with the hydrogen to create H2O, water. Space-based lasers are even more effective and create O3, ozone, in the process of creating water in the atmosphere. Water is the most essential element in the weather. The amount of it at any given point in time at a given location can create wind shifts, rain, obviously, snow, hint, hint, but a clever use of it can create a tornado, or over water, a hurricane, hint, hint. Over warm ocean water, it can create a very powerful hurricane, and if created in the right position at the right time, prevailing winds will carry it where you want it to go. But far more effective than that technology is the HEART project in Alaska. This uses VLF, very low frequency energy pulses, bounced off the ionosphere to create extreme weather conditions anywhere in the world they wish to direct it. The Earth has a fundamental resonant frequency of 7.83 Hz. Anything that operates at that frequency risks disturbing all aspects of Earth, weather, earthquakes, etc. It depends upon the amount of power produced. HEART produces 1.7 gigawatts. Here are a couple of interesting quotes I found on one of the websites I visited. the 30 million Pentagon project, named HARP, High Frequency Active Aurora Research Program, is made to be more than 1.7 gigawatts, a billion watts, of radiated power into the ionosphere, the electrically charged layer above the Earth's atmosphere. Put simply, the apparatus is a reversal of a radio telescope, just transmitting instead of receiving. It will boil the upper atmosphere after heating and disturbing the ionosphere. The radiation will bounce back onto the Earth in for a form of long waves which penetrates our bodies, the ground, and the ocean. It goes on to say that a UN treaty proves weather control is real. We report news articles that Malaysia actually contracted with Russia Weather Modification Company to create a hurricane that would be directed close enough to clear the smoke and smog from Malaysia's cities without actually coming onto land to create devastation. The Russian company delivered and Malaysia had clear skies. Our information also tells us that not only can hurricanes be created, they can be dismantled should scientists so desire. And they certainly can be driven on the ocean, much like we drive our cars on roadways. Therefore, one has to ask why American scientists have allowed unprecedented hurricanes like Andrew to even come ashore. Why are American scientists allowing extensive damage and lives lost to recent unprecedented storms, since they have the capability to keep these storms away from us? Goes on to say that these arrogant, reckless use of force energy into the ionosphere. Military scientists talk about kicking things into high gear just to see what would happen. Maybe just to see how people would react, government would react, etc. And I'll give you a link if you want to read more. It's quite extensive. Alright, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.